Welcome, Planeswalkers, to Magic Duels. I'm your host, Roman, and today more battles are waiting for us. We are gonna let our zombies loose on the fields one more time, and hopefully they'll bring us more victories and more ranks. At least this is what I'm hoping for. Yet, of all the decks I have right now, I think this one is the most competitive. Again, I told you I like some decks which are settling the board and things like that. But again, easy to play and easy to use decks are somewhat my cup of tea too, I guess. And the zombies, man. The zombies. What else? Let's see if our opponent can keep up. We have a great starting hand. We can already start to use the effect of Creep Breaker if we need to. So we're gonna keep it. And bring our immortal jackal out. And now this way I'm not going to be able to use the Grim Breaker. And those lands, man. Yeah. And just gets more land, right? You see, it's overpowered. I'm sorry, this land is just too overpowered. And yes, we are going to... I think I'm actually going to lay on the Oketra Monument this time. Or maybe not. Nah, I'm not going to wait. Well, I don't have a choice. I can bring our white dude out since we don't have any planes. And we do have somewhat bit of the control with the Cartouche of Ambition, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. What is this? More lands, I guess? Yeah. So maybe he's running an Eldrazi deck since he's getting so many lands out. I have an image in my hand with like a big, huge Titan Eldrazi and like tiny little zombies crumbling on him. Like the Eldrazi is overrun by the infection. I can skip it now. Now it's like the elephants climb on the ants climb on elephants. Yeah. Okay. We may be able to get to his face before we actually need to worry about him summoning his Eldrazi friends out. It looks like he's thinking out, for better or worse. I do like, since I'm recording on my external hard drive, when I'm recording in, it's flashing. So I know it's like going in and out the light. So I know what the software is running. Which is somewhat good thing. But it doesn't work for everything. As I already told, I had some problems with my another series, Arjubale. I recorded the video. But I didn't tap in recording the big stop. So I just had the audio of the whole day I played in this game. Yeah. But again, since I already told you, since the saves are from day to day, we were able just to redo it again. And I had some same trouble with Magic Duels. It was a bit different. It was like I was getting stomped in a row for 4 or 5 duels in which I tried to explain my changes to the deck, so I did the explaining like 3 or 4 times, and in the final video I think I didn't even, well, I said that I changed but I didn't actually show it, so yeah, sometimes it's hard. And it looks like it's bugged out. I know I have the internet connection. Yes, everything is working fine on my end. I do hope it will resume quite soon. Maybe I'll just quit and cut it out. I would not like to lose any rankings on this stupid sync problem. Again, it's not even on my end, so I don't know why I should be penalized for it. Alrighty, alrighty. I'm gonna stop here, and if it resumes, well, if it resumes when everything's fine, if it doesn't, you might just see me starting another duel straight out. So, see ya soon. Well, since I didn't resume, I'll just go to the next opponent, and it's the first time I seeing this planeswalker. Which probably should be the face of the guys we played against. Slayer. Alright. Nice to meet you, Slayer, and you have a lot of cards in your deck. You have a really good hand, but not enough land, so we'll just draw a new one. And this is a good hand too. And the full art lands. And the boat back jacket. Yeah, you might be in trouble. Might be. But who knows? I don't. I'm gonna stick to it. And the black, so control. And green, some more lands. Or trample. Yeah, this might be interesting. Defender. Ah, right, it's a life finger. Yeah. Nearly have enough to actually use the Liana Mastery. And the cartouche, with the cartouche we will be able to get to his face next turn. So just summon the servant. And he's gonna get buffed by the cartouche, and we're going to put the minus one counter on him. We're gonna skip the attack, there's no point in attacking, he can always just block us. Yeah. More land. And the planeswalker. What does it she do? Ah, -2/-1. So she'll be able to just kill us straight away. Yeah. But again, we can bring him out. Lifelink, putting the count on him. And attacking his planeswalker. Yeah, please do. He will sacrifice this to keep his planeswalker alive. And again, with the effect -2/-1, sure, he will be able to just slow us down for nearly ever. And we just need to not let him use his effect of 7. Ah, the Vizier of the Poisons, of course. That we are actually able to tap her. And we will. For better or worse. Yeah, I'll slow down his planeswalker. He attacks, we can just use the festering mummy effect on her and then put the -1/-1 counter again on her to kill her. The Vizier of Poison. Ah, I see now what he's doing. He's doing the -1/-1 effect and he's getting out his defending thingy. Not bad. He can kill our zombie with the effect of this, but since he used this, he'll not be able to. And he's just getting a ton of life. Yeah. And he should not attack me with her. Since he knows what I'm going to do, yes, and he can always use her effect to get rid of my mummy either way. But since we got this, we'll be able to tap one of his creatures. I don't think it's gonna be enough. Yeah, we can tap her, attack with everything, but he'll be able to block with two, so only one of ours will get through to him. Either way, we are going to summon the... And to summon this back, you need to have a few cards. It doesn't have Death Touch. So shall we just tap on his defenders? It doesn't really matter. Yeah, let's just tap one of his defenders. And we really don't want to use the Binding Mummy, so we'll not attack with it. But we should have attacked. No, Festering Mummy is something I'm going to use to defend against his Apache. Alright, so he's just going to sacrifice his one thing. But again, if we can draw a land, all of our zombies are gonna be so much stronger. We're gonna need one more land to be able to break through his wall. He has only 3 cards in his hand since he got so many lands. Let's see, if he does manage to minus 1 on our Festering Zombie, his Apache is getting the counter. Haha! He's thinking about it. Ah, he's actually going to sacrifice it to get a creature from the graveyard. I wonder who it's gonna be. Maybe the Soul Stinger? Who knows? Yeah, the Soul Stinger, alright. So he'll get the snake. And he'll be able to use the Mice on his encounter. On his on his snake, to kill his snake, basically. On the, I think he's gonna put it on the rope. Or on himself. Yeah, so he is planning on using his effect against us. One counter, so getting one more snake out. But again, he's just losing so many cards for it. And yes, we can finally use the Liliana thingy. That will not be able to tap his snakes. No, actually, we will be able to tap his snakes, but then we'll not be able to do something else. Alright, let us do this. I should just tap two of his snakes. Yeah, I think so. Just because it will be troublesome. And please don't lag on me anymore. Yep, two and plus two. I'm tapping two creatures. And I don't care if we lose. And it's only two counters, so our servants should still be alive. Yeah, I'll do it like this. I know he can block. Is it, but I'm going to put a counter on it and get two counters on myself this way. Yeah. Ah, it has 3 counters on it. So did I miscalculate something? Well, whatever. It's too late to be thinking about it right now. And what are you? So, yeah, he's just putting my sword on my sword counter and getting more snakes out. Huh. At least we know he'll not attacking us. Will not attack us this time, because he's playing keeping them alive too. And now my thing about Apatra is backfiring. Or is it? Yeah, but we'll need to get rid of all of his snakes. But the menace will be great for it. So let's just do this. It doesn't really matter what I'm going to tap. So I'm not playing on attacking. And then are we able to summon one or fewer cards? But we will be able to give them menace, so he'll need to sacrifice more than he actually needs to. Yeah, he'll just put one snake in each thing. I think I've lost that. I've lost that initiative. Yeah, he's just going to add more counters. Yeah, and more snakes. Those snakes are really troublesome. And we do have menace. Should we just sacrifice a zombie for it? No, I don't think we need to. Again, our goal is to bring to kill him, so the HP we lose is not a big problem here. But this will give first strike, so it will actually like make someone immune for to our zombie, our problem, our snake problem. But again, he will be able to kill our first strike dude if he only adds a zombie to the mix. Should we buff the binding? No, the binding arm is too important. And should we give minutes to him? Our lifelink get rid of one of the snakes. Right, I'm going to take the risk. Get rid of one of his snakes. No, not one of his snakes actually. But one of the minus one counter on Apatra. And attack with it. She has the first strike. So if he puts the snakes, I'll just kill the snakes. Right? This is how it works? Yes, I'm just killing the snakes. That's great, actually. We got rid of two snakes. But we don't have any more cards, but we do have a stomp that we can bring out again and again. And this deals damage and heals us, right? Ah no, two minus one counters. Alright. So he's getting more snakes out. Why is he attacking? We don't have lifelink. And now we can actually get rid of all of his snakes. What a plague belcher. And get rid of this. And he has already menace. Now we'll just bring our immortal zombie out. Yeah. We're going to tap this so he'll not be able to kill our first strike dude. And we could give menace to him too. I don't think we need 5, right? Yeah, so we will be able to kill all the snakes with it. Should I give him menace so it will not be able to block? Yeah, let's try it. Let's see if he has actually. Why? You should not be able to block. Well, whatever. I guess I misread or something. Again, this should. So it's. Why? This is your problem. My first strike, dude. Ah, but now he has enough snakes to actually kill it. No, he doesn't. So I don't understand what he did. I guess he'll just put all of them on this dude to make him... Yeah, this is what I think he's going to do. Creature to tap. One of his four freeze, please. And on this. Again, we don't need to give him first strike yet, but we will give menace. Oh, maybe we don't need, we can actually just wait. And run the belch in his face. No, let's. Yeah, but he'll block with those two and kill me. And kill him. Which we don't really need to do, but this we can. It doesn't really matter since we can always bring him back, so. I'll just attack with it. Ah, I forgot to give menace to him. Well, whatever. But he's gonna get the damage since the zombies died. We still have our first strike dude. And the Belcher is actually able to get rid of his... Ah, the beetle, of course. Of course, the beetle. But the beetle, we will be able to kill the beetle. Too technical for my liking. Should we do this and bring out the zombie? No. I do believe he'll try to keep his beetle alive, so I'll just tap this. And yes, since I can't use the effect to give him first sight, I'll just summon the zombie attack again. I can give him first strike, so one snake may kill our Belcher. So, it doesn't really matter. This means we can attack with this. Ah, we don't have enough mana to give the menace. Wow, my brain is like overheating right now, you know? Again, he's just going to sacrifice his snake. And if he attacks with Beetle, we'll just kill him with Belcher. Ah, okay, so he's getting more snakes out, putting more mines through myself. At this point, I think I should start to sacrifice the snake, you know? So one more snake is out. But this creature is not that powerful anymore. He will be able to kill Lord of the Curse at some point. But not yet. Ha! Huh. Plus 2 plus 2, but still it is gonna die. And now Belcher is it. So to whom should we give the first strike now? It's another one of our zombies. And I'll give menace. And attack with our 4-3 Dread Wanderer who will be back. Now you can have 2 snakes for the price of 1. Yay! And 1 more HP. Yeah, the fast deck and slow phase. I'm quite excited actually. I am quite excited. We do have 4 creatures with first strike right now. So he can just kill one of his. But maybe he has a buff card. But we'll see. Again, I think it's only gives 2. So I might do it just like that. It is his turn to think, right? So why is it not like showing the time or something like that? Is it bugged again? No. Oof. Fine, I lost 4 HP but get rid of 2 of his creatures. Which is a win in my book. And I'm not... No, wait, wait, wait. Let me give menace directly. Yeah, attack. It's really actually helpful having a creature that can just die. And I do believe I have both of them in my deck. So, maybe we'll draw one more. Do I want to kill the snake or the Divine Great Mojo? The Great Mojo. Great Mom. Grim Joyce from the Bleach. Okay, yeah, we'll just bring you back. And he's gonna, our opponent is gonna lose 1 more HP. Just tapping for fun right now. That soon I'll be able to just run to his face and win. Soon. Especially if we give menace to all of our things, he'll just not be able to block all of them. Yeah, that Planeswalker. I don't think he'll be able to do it just straight away. Use her. Oh no, here she comes. And it will be somewhat hard to get to her. Again, we'll see. It looks like he's just using the evolution on his snake. Well, X is a 2 plus the sacrifice creature costs. Since it was 1. Yeah. Wait. Why is he able to bring this big thing? X or less, where X is a plus. Wait, why was he able to bring this one? And who does he killed? I don't remember. So this to stop his creatures. Should we just try and go to his face? He can block two creatures of mine. Two creatures. So at least, at maximum, he can block 9 damage. We have 2, 6, 2, 6, 10, 11. So we can actually go to his face, I believe. We have a little. Can I block two creatures? So 8, 9, 10, 11. Attack with all him. I do believe my calculations are right, and it's over. Now you can block his menace. Yep, we have won. Feel alive, you know. I like this is dual duels, how it goes. I don't like to lose at the slow pace, but this was just too good. Let's see what we get from the booster. We finally got her out. I wish visionary Nissa evolving wilds like Crassus, the Blessed Spirits, and of course Liliana. Yes. Plus 2, each player discards a card. Minus 6, return target creature from the graveyard onto the battlefield. And 8, you get an emblem. But the problem is, it will make us discard a lot of cards. So maybe she's not as good as I thought. That means, but it's plus 2 each turn. So basically need to do it for 3 turns, so 3 cards. Get now when every creature dies, turn to the battlefield under your control. But then, if you do, okay. Whenever another non-token creature you control dies, exile her, and in turn can transform under her own control. Her owner's control. If you do, token onto the battlefield. So you must have to transform her. And then it becomes this. Plus 2 each turn. 3 turns at least. I'm going to put her in a zombie deck. Since I don't see how we are going to be able to keep her alive. But maybe, just maybe, I should put her in a new deck. Alright, I'm not gonna do it straight away. So don't worry, guys. And if I do, I'll tell you. Thank you all for watching. It was Roman. Take it easy. Have a good one. See ya next time. Bye bye.